officially the first workout of the 50 workouts in 50 countries series. As you saw, I did a little run through the city. This is such a beautiful city. We're in Vancouver. If you haven't been watching any of my other videos yet, if you haven't seen those yet, go watch them, because we've done our absolute best to make it feel like you've been on this trip with us. So here's the deal. I reached out to a couple private gyms and no one really was into having me work out there, and it didn't work out. And then the public gyms here would not let us film. So we are working out in a hotel gym. But the good thing about that is a lot of times when you're traveling, you don't have access to gyms there and you have to figure out what kind of workout you can do in a gym space like this. I also have a feeling that on a lot of our trips and stuff, we're not necessarily gonna have access to a full gym. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm going to come up with the best workout that I can that you can do in a gym space like this. It's pretty limited. It has a few random machines, some dumbbell weights that are really weird. Looks like they made them. So what I'm gonna do, instead of doing like an isolation workout like I normally do, because normally I have a 6-day rotation where I'm hitting a different muscle group each day, but today I'm gonna do a workout that's almost like a full body workout. Because also, like when you're traveling, you might not be working out every day, so you need to be able to get as much in as you can when you do work out. So I'm gonna do like a full body workout, walk you guys through that, show you what I'm doing, and hopefully when you're traveling, this is something that you could use, or even when you're home and you don't have access to a full gym, but this is something that you could do. I'm gonna push it still. Like, you might not have as much equipment as normally, but I'm still gonna push it. Hopefully, if you try to do this workout and you follow along, it'll kick your ass. That's the goal. So let's get started. I'm gonna start out here with some lunges with some dumbbells. Actually, I like doing it with a barbell on my back. That's kind of curved. I can still use it and put that on my back. So I'm gonna do some lunges, and we'll start with that and move on to a few other things. I don't know how much this weighs. Is there close? Alright. It works like this. So I'm gonna do, it's not very much weight, I'll probably do 10 reps on each side. So that's the first set there. I'm gonna do 4 sets. I'm gonna take about a minute breather here. There's no clock in here. Try to keep it to a minute though. So use your phone or something if you have to. And the other thing, like when you're doing your workout, and you, most people you see them, you're on your phone, you're texting. And I'm just a big believer that to get a really good workout, it's important to focus and think about what you're doing. Try to block out all those distractions and try to focus on your workout. You're in here to do work, you're not in here to text. You know, you're in here to work on yourself and make progress. So if you need to use your phone, use it as a timer, pick the next song, find that song that's gonna push you, and go right back into your next set. That's what we're gonna do right here. Another set of 10 on each side. Second set. I'm gonna do 2 more sets. We're not gonna film. I'm gonna go ahead and jump into those now, and I'll pick up with you guys again after I'm done with these. Got my heart rate up. Told you, if you do this right, still get a good workout in a little gym like this. Next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna stay with legs. I'm gonna really focus on our hamstrings right here. Did you hear how I said focus? Almost sounded like a Canadian. We've been here for a week. It's rubbing off. All right, eh? So we're gonna do some stiff-legged deads. You're really focused on squeezing through your glutes and your hamstrings. This is something that Kai Green, if you don't know who he is, professional bodybuilder, he's unbelievable. I watched this on one of his videos. I've been using it ever since. What he says is you like screw your heels into the ground. And when you go down, you try to push your heels out, but they're really not gonna actually move. But you're feeling like you're trying to push your heels out like that. And when you do, it opens up your hamstrings even more. And you can feel it pull on your hamstrings more so than when you do it that way. And I can feel it. So opposed to when you're just doing it normal, you still feel it. But when you just, that little slight movement, I can feel a big difference. So try that out sometime. So I'm gonna go 4 sets of 12 on this one. Try to really squeeze those glutes at the top like that. Kick your glutes back, slightly bend your knees, stretch up, contract, squeeze your glutes. I like to really push my hips forward right there and get a good squeeze. Doing it in a gym like this and didn't necessarily have dumbbells like that, barbell like that, you can use dumbbells too. I'll show you that really quick. Same movement. I like to have the weight about shoulder width apart, kind of hanging when you come down. I grab two different weights. When you come down, I like to let the weight come out in front of me like that, and then I bring it back here, just like that. So just in case that the gym you're using doesn't have a barbell, that's what you can do. Leave that out, we'll use that anyways. Another thing too is a lot of gyms like this don't have a lot of weight, so it's good to do a lot of reps, get a lot of volume in, because you'll still get a good workout. My legs are starting to feel it. It's probably not the best workout to do right before we leave and walking through the airport sore, but that's fine. So we've hit 2 leg movements, we've worked our glutes, our hamstrings, and our quads. Now I'm gonna move on to a arm workout. We're gonna do biceps first and then move to triceps. I'm just gonna use this same weight. I'm not gonna switch it up, but just leave it the way it is. And do some standing curl variations. So keep your elbows to your side. Don't let them come forward. Don't rock with it. Just stay right here. Come straight up with it and squeeze at the top. We're gonna start with a wide grip and we're gonna alternate with a close grip on the next set. You'll see what I mean. We'll do 4 sets of 16. I'm gonna do the wide grip first, and then I'm gonna move to close grip here in a second and hit the second set. Now we're gonna do the close grip, meaning on an easy bar curl like this, grabbing right inside here, coming straight up, same motion, everything. And let the weight down like this. You'll see people doing curls like this. It doesn't count. All the way down. I'll talk to you about why here in a second. The reason why you want to let it all the way down is when you come down, you work the lower part of your bicep head. If you stay right here, see how my arm comes down? How that comes down like that? If you don't do that, then you never hit that part. You're still gonna use it a little bit, but if you're really trying to shape your bicep and get a good shape, do you know what I mean? Like, you wanna go lower so that way you can hit that. I'm gonna do one more set, close grip. After that, that'll be my 4th set. And then I'll pick up here, we'll do some triceps. Triceps. We're gonna do some dumbbell tricep extensions. I'm gonna lay down on this bench. I'm gonna walk you through the movement as I do it. It'd be a lot easier to explain on these. So
So, keeping your elbows about shoulder width apart. Let the weight come back. It's kind of like a skull crusher back here by your head. And then as you come up, I want you to turn your palms out and squeeze. As I do this, I can feel it right here in my tricep head. And as I turn out, I'm squeezing and feeling it right there in your tricep. Don't try to like lock your elbows real hard. Your arms are gonna be pretty straight, but really try to squeeze through your tricep. We're gonna do the same thing reps wise on here as we did for the curls. We'll do 4 sets of 16. Because I did so many reps, it was still very difficult. The last 4 or 5 of them was pretty hard. So we'll go ahead and do 3 more sets of that. And then they actually have a pretty decent back setup over here, so we'll do some lat pull downs after this. We're gonna do a variation on these, but this wide grip bar will work for both things. We're going to do 4 sets again. First set, we're gonna do a wide grip like this. Just this way. And we're gonna go sets of 25 this time. So a lot of reps right here. For the second set. So here, our palms are facing away from us. On these sets, we're gonna bring our grip in a little bit closer, and our palms are gonna face towards us. So we'll do another set of 25. I'm gonna drop the weight a little bit because when I'm going this way, it's a little bit harder. I'm a little bit out of breath because I'm doing this high volume workout. I usually do. Lately, if you haven't been following my channel, I've been on a bulk for the last couple months. My shred starts March 1st. So I've still been getting volume into my workouts, but it's been through doing a lot of sets of like 12 to 14, sometimes even 8 reps, and then doing a lot more sets to still get the volume in. So right now, as I'm doing these high rep sets, my cardio is lagging a little bit, but we'll be all right. Let's jump into this, let's go. Focus on really squeezing at the bottom. You can feel the pull in your lats right here. Let it all the way out, feel your lats extend. The bottom, try to squeeze your lats, squeeze your shoulder blades together. And try to pull with your lats first, not your biceps. When your palms are facing towards you, it's easier to activate your biceps. So you have to really focus on, when you're doing your movement, pulling with your back, your lats, your shoulders first, and then your biceps. Because otherwise you're just doing biceps. Two more sets, one of each. That'll give us 100 reps on here. So we're about 300 reps in now, and we've hit our legs, we've hit our biceps, our triceps, our back. And the last thing that we're gonna do, actually we're gonna do two more things. We're gonna do shoulders, and we're gonna do chest. That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. One thing, I don't know if you guys noticed, but when I was doing overhand, my thumb was on top. When I was doing underhand, my thumb was on top as well. And the reason why I do that, I found for me personally, when my thumb is on top instead of wrapped, it makes me use my lat more than if it's wrapped, because I feel like when my hand is like this or like this, I'm able to use my bicep more. So when my thumb is not like that, it makes me have to use my lat more. That's just me, try it out. All right, we're gonna go straight over here into some shoulder press, military press, dumbbells. Just push this bench up to some volume reps on here as well. Not very much weight, there's only 35. So I'll probably do 16 to 20 reps, and we'll do four sets again. A really good testament to is that you don't have to use a lot of weight to get an intense workout. And if you go slow and your form's right and you're really focusing on getting a good squeeze and contraction, you can still get a hell of a workout and not have to use heavy weight. I'm gonna go right into this second set. My cardio is killing me right now. It'll get better once my shred starts. But we're gonna go ahead and push it right now. If I'm pushing it, if you're watching this, you better push it too. Let's go. And then we're gonna use that chest press machine over there. I was wanting to do dumbbell bench, but 35s, even if we go real slow, it's not really gonna be enough. So luckily, they do have a chest press machine, so we'll finish with that. I lied, we're not gonna be finished. That'll be the last weight workout that we're gonna do, but then I'm gonna have a finisher. Shoulders are on fire. We're gonna go over here and do that chest press. Actually,
I lied again. You guys aren't gonna trust me now. I'm gonna do some delt flies. I wanna work the outside of my delts. Doing overhead press works more so the front of your shoulders and the back. I wanna do some delt flies real quick. I'm gonna do a drop set. I'm gonna do two drop sets. And I'm gonna do 15 reps, drop set, 15 more reps. I'm gonna do that twice. And then we'll go over and hit the chest machine. That was good. It sucked. It was hard, but I'm glad I did it. It just works a different part of your shoulder. Let's go over here and hit this chest machine. So even though this is different, obviously, than a free weight dumbbell or barbell bench press, I still want you to treat it the same as far as your setup. I want you to really focus on squeezing your shoulder blades together, keeping your elbows in, just like this, squeezing through your chest. Instead of doing a bunch of high volume on here, I'm gonna go four sets of 12 and go a little bit heavier. Make sure that weight's coming all the way even with your chest. You're not half repping like this. Let it all the way come all the way down. Feel a good stretch. And squeeze at the top. All right, 12. I'm gonna bump the weight some more. Struggle stash. Hit 12 more. Take about 30 seconds to a minute here. Go right into it. Same thing, same setup. Even though we use more weight, we're not sacrificing form. Two sets, I'm gonna do four more. I'm gonna go up and wait one more time. We're not showing off here, we're just pushing it. Sets of 12 there. We're done with weights. But that doesn't mean it's gonna get easier. This finisher right here is gonna be hell, but I promise you'll be glad you did it. Let's walk over here and I'll show you what we're gonna do. So, since we've done like a full body workout, the finisher, if you're on Team Britton Russ Fitness, you know all about these, or if you followed my channel for a while. So usually on like a chest day, a finisher will be like a push-up variation. Depending on what muscle group we're hitting that day, the finisher is usually for that muscle group, just to exhaust that muscle, break it down as much as possible, build a little endurance. So today, since we're doing a full body workout, I'm gonna incorporate the compound lift, which will be the push-ups. We're gonna use our chest and our triceps and our shoulders a little bit, and then we're gonna do air squats. Now, you might say, Brent, air squats, no weight, really, that's too easy. Trust me, this will kick your ass, literally. So we're gonna start out and we're going to do 10 or 20 push-ups. Let's do 20. I was gonna say 10, but let's push it. Let's do 20. So 20 push-ups, you're gonna stand up, you're gonna do 20 air squats, okay? We're gonna do 5 rounds and we're gonna try not to take any breaks. So that's gonna be 200 reps total between the two. That'll put us over 500 reps for today's workout. We're in this little shitty gym, but this still should be really intense if you're doing these right. And you're doing what we talked about earlier. Not flying through your reps, flying on the weight around, controlling your reps, using good form, focusing on squeezing and contracting. If you're doing that, this should be a hard workout. I don't even want to do this, but we're gonna do it. All right, we're gonna start with push-ups, then go into the air squats. Ready, set, go. And it sucks, and you know it's gonna be a battle. That's what this is gonna be. We're not gonna cut. I know I'm getting a little bit of a break, this isn't fair, and I'm talking to you guys. We're not gonna cut, so you can see that I do all of them, but from here on out, we're gonna speed it up a lot, so that way this doesn't get boring. Let's go, round two. I hope you guys are doing exactly what I'm doing right now. Number one, that you did them all. You didn't cheat. And you're dying. My cardio, man. This lean bulk cardio is out the window. I'm actually excited to start cutting. I like being able to eat more carbs, a little bit more fat. But I don't like feeling slow. When I'm cutting, I'm eating right, I'm light. I feel a lot quicker, I feel healthier. Even though it's really not. When you're in a deficit, it's not as healthy for you as when you're in a surplus or at your right caloric intake. So that wraps the official first workout of 50. I hope it kicked your ass. I'm gonna try to make all of these workouts really good, intense. Not just like a going through the emotions thing to do, just to say we did the workout.
My goal is for all 50 of these workouts to be really hard, good, informational workouts that you guys can implement. So when we get done with this series, if someone wants to, they can just look back at all the 50 workouts, do that for 50 days, and be in shape. How awesome would that be? They watch 50 different workout videos in 50 different countries, and it gets their ass in shape. I think that's pretty cool. So, I hope you enjoyed this and you didn't enjoy it because it kicked your ass. So, this isn't the last video for here in Canada. This does wrap the workout. Hope you guys have enjoyed all the other videos since we've been here. The run this morning, seeing the city. We got one more coming your way that I think you guys are gonna think is amazing too. Appreciate all the love and support that we're getting. This is what it's all about. See you guys in the next video. Bye.